Hi everybody, today is February 18th, 2013. This article had an interesting aspect to it. Area gun theft rose 36% in 2012. I believe this is New York. Serial numbers, description, critical, and locating weapons. But a lot of the time, local police never notified state police that a gun was even stolen. Plattsburgh reported gun larcenies increased 36% in state police troop B areas in 2012. In terms of total firearms, the number is up 37 over the 141 cases handled in 2011 by all law enforcement agencies in Troop B's area, comprising Clinton, Essex, Franklin, St. Lawrence, and other northern Hamilton counties. In the Tri-County area, gun owners in Clinton County were hardest hit, with 66 reported stolen in 2012. That's a spike from the 28 firearm cases in 2011. Essex County followed with 25 guns reported swiped in 2012, a slight increase from the previous year. 13 guns reported stolen in Franklin County last year represents a 50% decrease from 2011. Some local law enforcement agencies failed to report their gun thefts case to the state police, according to senior investigator Christopher Kenniston, who works in Troop B's Gun Investigation Unit in Raybrook. While he guesses there could be as much as 10% gap between state police data and the actual reported cases, he said, "I think we're dealing with a fairly accurate information. Last year we had several reported handguns stolen from either residents or vehicles," said Plattsburgh City Police Chief Desmond Rassicott. A drug-related arrest in the city eventually led police to a weapon that was stolen from the Plattsburgh area, he said. It was recovered in Brooklyn in November of 2012 with the help of New York City Police. In 2012, 73% of those reporting long guns stolen were not able to give police a serial number or an accurate description of the weapon, Kensington said. "That's a common issue. It makes our job extremely difficult in trying to solve these crimes," he said. "What we find is most people don't have good documentation on any of their property," Rassicott said. Gun owners should record their firearms manufacturer or importer, model name, serial number, type and action, caliber or gauge, data acquired, costs, and the purchase location. This information should be kept separate from the firearms, Kensington said. "Most people do not store their firearms in gun safes due to the high cost of those storage units," he said. "A gun safe is what we promote," he said, "but using a trigger lock can deter some thieves." Rassicott said that in all the cases he has investigated, the guns were secure within the home, but they were unsecured in the houses, put in a closet or a cabinet. When a gun is reported stolen, its serial number, if available, is entered into a national database as a permanent record until the weapon is recovered, Kensington said. And state police will send a stolen property flyer with a description to the area dealers, even if the serial number isn't known. While dealers aren't required by law to check a firearm serial number to make sure it wasn't stolen, they will usually notify police if they think its ownership is suspect, he said. Stolen guns have a myriad of fates. When guns are stolen, they're being taken for value, Kensington said. Some thieves may use them for protection, swap them for drugs or money, or keep them as collectibles, he said. "What bothers me is I know criminals are keeping them." Gun theft cases are considered serious crimes by Plattsburgh City Police because they threaten the safety of the community, Rassicott said. "Even if we only had one gun reported stolen, that gun's on the street. It's not legally owned. We won't know who has it, what the intended purpose would be, and how careless that person could be with the weapon," the chief said. The majority of stolen guns were taken during the course of burglaries that occurred in summer and fall, Kensington said. "Most are thefts of opportunity. There are very few residents that are targeted because of guns. Most homes from which firearms are stolen are located in rural areas," he said. "People are going to a house where they think they can get away with a break-in, not to be seen. Almost all guns reported stolen in 2012 were taken from private residences, with a few swiped from vehicles during hunting season," Kensington said. Several homes hit had significant collection, with more than a dozen rifles, he said. Gun dealers in Troop B's area haven't fallen victim to theft in recent years, he noted. "Unfortunately, most guns are gone for good. Historically, law enforcement recovers about 25%, Kensington said. "Those found may not surface until weeks, months, or years have passed since the initial theft," he said. "We recovered guns all over the nation, including Canada and New York City. For the vast majority of the 8,793 guns recovered and traced statewide in 2011, the time to crime period. The time has passed between the guns theft and the occurrence of the crime that led us to recovery. Was 3 years or longer, according to the U.S. Department of Justice Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearm, and Explosive Office of Strategic Intelligence and Information. The top three cities in New York for gun recovery were New York City, Rochester, and Buffalo, the agency reported. Kensington said it was too early to tell how the newly passed New York Secure Ammunition and Firearms Enforcement Act may affect gun theft. Those who are found to be knowingly in possession of a stolen gun are charged with fourth-degree criminal possession of stolen property, a felony. And they give a link here where you can get a form to record your gun's information. So just in case it's ever stolen, maybe you might be one of the 25% that do get your guns back. And that is, of course, it's used in a crime, and then they probably keep it forever. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.